Anna Howard Shaw, 1847 to 1919, grew up in the backwoods of Michigan. The memories of pioneer hardships never left her. She became a preacher and then a physician. Her interest and activity in the Women's Christian Temperance Union was her introduction to the suffrage movement. She was one of its great orators. In 1904, she became the president of the National American Woman Suffrage Association. Dr. Shaw speaks of her work with prostitutes in her early careers as a preacher and then as a doctor.
When I started out in life, I made up my mind that I would become a missionary and would go to the women who, more than others, need friends and yet suffer the greatest abuses. So I studied theology and, when I graduated, thinking I knew something about what I had undertaken, I attempted to help the homeless and the forsaken and the betrayed women of the community. In a little while, I found that I had nothing to give that they wanted, and I also found out that, although I knew something about theology, I knew very little about human beings, for I learned that it is useless to talk virtue to a starving girl. I looked around and found that I could do practically little. But, I thought, there is one woman who does do something, and that is a doctor. For a woman doctor can go to these women when they are sick and suffering, and minister to them, and bring them some sort of relief and comfort. So I went back to school and studied medicine and took my degree, and again went down into the byways to live and to work, and unceasingly try to do something to be helpful. At the end of 3 years, I gave up in utter despair. The same desperate problems that had faced all other workers in such lines faced me also. What is needed first of all for these poor girls is some rational satisfaction for their human nature. What they need is employment under conditions which shall not crush out and atrophy all their natural human demands. What is needed is a fair chance for each, a fair day's wage for a fair day's work. I believe so much in women's working. I believed then in work, but under conditions that left the worker human after the day's toil was done. I believed that working women should have in life this human satisfaction. This is why, then as now, I wanted to do my share, to see that other toilers got an equal day's pay for an equal day's work, regardless of whether they were men or women. But I found that women are a branded sex, and I saw that, so long as women are branded as the inferior sex and men are distinguished as the superior sex, there is no hope in the market of the world of an equal day's pay for an equal day's work. There is no fair chance anywhere until that stigma is removed, which declares women an inferior sex in the business of life.